can't quite see.
Okay.
See too well.
Okay.
It's a little dark in here. Thank you.
Would you turn off the moon?
I think that's against the regulations of the space.
Okay.
Okay. So better not this time.
Okay. Okay. Let's ask this person something.
Hello.
Hello. So, why are you so difficult to love?
How much time do we have?
As much time as you want. Yeah, as much time as you want.
Actually, I'm not difficult to love.
Oh. Yeah.
Oh.
Thank you. Thank you. Are you gonna give him the cards? Oh, thank you. I almost forgot. So, could you do me a favor, please?
Sure.
Yeah, okay. So, while you're listening to the text, please listen for four objects of desire that are mentioned in the text and write them each down on one card.
Did you give him the pen?
No. There you go.
Okay.
Okay.
All right, thank you. All right. Where's our judging person back here? Oh, it's Daniela. Hello. Hello, Daniela. So,
put the lantern right there.
We're about to watch a video.
Mm-hmm.
And on this video, you're going to see two animals
mm-hmm.
having a conversation.
Mm-hmm.
Animal A and Animal B. But there's no sound. So you and I are going to impersonate the voices of the animals, what they're talking about.
Oh,
okay?
Wonderful.
It's very difficult. We're going to do our best. I'm going to be number A there on the left, and you're going to be B on the right, okay?
I'm on the right. Okay.
We're going to share this microphone.
You ready?
We're ready.
I'm ready.
All right. Hello there, Daniela. Thank you for joining me at this trash bin today.
Thank you so much. I really, truly love dumpster diving.
Oh, yeah, me too. So I got a question for you. Would you say you're a good judge of character?
I would say I'm a bad judge of character.
What are the consequences of that?
People can get angry at you if you tell them to their face.
That they're a bad person?
Or maybe they are a good person and they're actually a bad person. They could be angry about that.
All right, thank you very much. Very interesting.
Oh, I got a close project.
I can do it. You go ahead.
Thank you. So, I have many values written on these cards, or rather flags. Please select your top five values, and you can throw the rest away.
Okay, like I can just look at them and choose?
Yes, take your time. There's quite a few.
I think there's 34.
Yeah.
That's how many values there are in this world. Simone is throwing away ambition. No, not ambition.
Okay. That's out. That's out.
Let's see. Honesty. Wow. That's
you could throw that one away if you're a performer of some kind.
Okay. Well, I did learn about money last year, so wealth is a tricky thing, but money is whirled around, sadly, or not. Responsibility. God, this is hard.
Yes.
just like fumbling with values. Not modesty.
Modesty.
This is I like courage. Courage and value. Let's see. Faith would be a tricky one. Let's see. Loyalty could be dating a narcissist.
Oh no, I hope everybody heard that. That's a warning to everybody.
I do like creativity. You guys know I like that one. generosity. There's responsibility. Let's see. Plurality. I like plurality. I don't know if I can choose five. Is it only five?
We'll choose five at random if you choose more. Is that alright?
Privacy, oh gosh, privacy. This is empty. This is so hard. Okay, well I think I'm getting overwhelmed.
Sorry about that.
Yeah.
It's the objects too. They're very strange.
Yes. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so I guess out of these, I do like plurality. Mm. I definitely keep that one. Creativity, I like that one. Wealth, can I just trade that to money?
Well, it is an obvious and valuable thing, right?
It is. Mm-hmm. We need money.
Mm-hmm. This is just.
Courage. 1, 2, 3, 4. It's between authenticity and pleasure. So I'm just gonna close my eyes and choose one.
It was plurality.
Or was it?
It was authenticity.
Authenticity.
Okay.
Thank
you so much, Simone. You can just put those on the ground by your chair. Thank you very much. Okay. Can I ask you a very personal question?
Yes.
Do you feel like you're in the right mental and emotional state for a very personal question?
Go ahead.
Okay. What do you think is the sexiest thing about yourself?
Oh, man. that's a good question. Sexiest thing. My intellect?
Very good. Thank you, Corey. All right. Wonderful. Intellect.
You got that, then. Okay.
So, does anyone here know you? Who here knows you the best?
I love you too. Well, no, I'm sorry. Probably David.
Okay. Right now, so April's filming right now. So maybe we can't ask. Is there anybody else
you can ask
you?
Me?
Okay.
I'm filming.
Okay.
It is now. It's on the recording. It's fine.
Okay.
I'll edit it out later. Or edit it in. Hold on. Let's see.
So if you could describe this person as if you were writing a novel or a screenplay about them.
It's probably like a... See, there are probably like a lot of words that end in the letter Z. be like, probably like, legs. Yeah, I mean, like, how long's the novel?
When you're done, you're done.
Yeah, mostly it's like, I mean, it's like a lot of these. There's probably, times, legs, things, places, and other stuff. All encased in this thing that you're talking about? That we're talking about? Are we all talking about it? Or just me? I've got a microphone. So I guess it's me.
Jeremy, take the microphone. Gerald's gonna turn on the light a little bit so you can see it.
Okay.
I got the lantern. Okay. I'm gonna give you the microphone.
Okay.
And then when you can see it, start reading.
Okay. Please read loudly and clearly in your most comfortable way. Anything and anyone could become a spectacle at any time. This is, in quotations, the self. Dancing chorus. In parentheses, nostalgia. Singing chorus. Score, in parentheses, check. Singers, in parentheses, check. Choreography, in parentheses, check. This is, in quotations, the nation state. This is, in quotations, the body. Head, arms, heart. This is, in quotations, theater. This is, in quotations, society. Scenery, costumes, orchestra with conductor. Non-singing extras, stage, bathrooms, lobby, grid, backstage, stage manager, stage hands, run crew, tickets, marketing materials, donors, patrons, box seats, super titles, bar, concessions. This is, in parentheses, the mind. Recordings of itself documentation, booth crew, lighting ops, soundboard ops, Sits probe, follow spot operator, epic sense of itself, narrative, cultural context, audience. Anything and anyone could become a spectacle at any time, even by floating face down in a flood.
All right, I'm gonna turn on the lights. So it's gonna be a moment. Just, you know, close your eyes maybe and then they're gonna come on. There they are, okay. Wow. Wow. Okay. Edward. So, there's gonna be a lot of reading aloud in this place. And you're first, okay? So you can go and sit on that box. There's a microphone. You're gonna be on the stage, okay? You don't have to stay there, but it would be great if you read the text, okay? And I'm not going to take this from you, Holes. Is it pinned? Mm-hmm. Oh, beautiful. Thank you very much. Okay.
Representing while character changes occur. Assonance is a good example of the echo. Also, the name of my firstborn, the donkey, an animal whose name is incorrectly pronounced, donkey, and then, more slowly, don't let the awning catch fire. What a great pie she made. What a slow performance. gaze is undulating with your gaze like a bobbing pear in a sea of saliva. This play is going to have a lot of reading aloud. Eventually, we made it out alive. Their name was Diamond. Their name was shared in a tent or when we stopped at the edge to appreciate the view. Low life. Garden number 2, movement 3, with Nate and Trio in C major, like Haydn's 95th. A garden is a planned space. A garden is usually out of a door is set aside for the growing and or display of plants. Jamartia is a system of recognizing correlations between the 10 sirfat, or fires of God, and the 22 letters of the Hebrew alphabet. This system is elaborated in many mystical writings such as Zohar. Jamartia is related systematically to Hamartia, which is Greek and a metal band. Ooh, Aristotle C. Theatron uses Hamartia to mean tragic mistake or tragic flaw. The co-notion that such flaws are predetermined is similar to the Christian concept of original sin. The word Hamartia literally means missing the mark. But in most works of literature and theater wherein one can find examples of Hamartia, it is an epic miss of the mark that leads to tragedy, usually death, see mistakes for more casual errors. In most examples found in classical Western, e.g. empirical, Hamartia is caused by the tragic flaw embodied by the protagonist, namely hubris. Hubris is pride, usually a pride that clouds decision-making. Hubris allows the powerful to harm the less powerful, to make decisions that should be left to the fates, and thus to rain death and suffering down on all. 2. The goddess Hubris spent time in the mortal world and was famously insolent and without interpersonal intelligence. Those whom the god would destroy, they first make proud. Suffice to say, Jamartia is the art of knowing which solid correlates to which symbol, while Hamartia is misinterpreting which solid correlates with which symbol. Why don't we see all the correlations correctly? Ah, silly. See tone. The things we see change. The way we see changes. How we see changes us, and we do not see all of us. Because that's outside of the situation. We do not see all of us. We are not all in positions of power. Does this mean our mistakes don't matter? Some things are out of sight. Both I can't see them and really excellent. See excellent. I must learn to live with that fact. See facts. It is epistemically, and ontologically possible, some may insist, for humans to become totally circumcised properties, circumscribed. As properties, we will be property of. And once properly property, forcibly prevented from biting. The Western theory is all of this. You will need to become less self-aware in order to survive. Do not come out of your duplex to patch with plasters or mix explosives in alliance with those far away to take down the facilities from well inside the first world. I am hungry, you're hungry too. This is my garden, this is your garden too. Shall we merely smash together some unlikely gestures steeped in this agony?
Someone in this room. Someone in this room is a whale who dies.
I am a whale who dies.
Someone in this room is making mistakes. Someone in this room is moving backwards through time. Someone in this room is a serial killer. Someone in this room is holding on to emails. Someone in this room has a full bank account. Someone in this room has a baby. Someone in this room is listening to... Someone in this room is a smoker who dies.
I'm a smoker who dies.
Someone in this room is believing in God. Someone in this room is gardening. Someone in this room has oral cancer. Someone in this room is a dyer who sings.
I'm a dyer who sings.
Someone in this room doesn't measure up to their parents' expectations. Someone in this room expects that bad things will happen to them. Someone in this room is a singer who wails.
I am a singer who wails.
Someone in this room is someone else's one true love. Someone in this room is still growing. Someone in this room is missing a bone. Someone in this room is representing. Someone in this room is interpreting. Someone in this room is judging. Someone in this room is valuing. And someone in this room is desiring.
text, please?
If only I could be narrow, hard, dry, sure. I am trying to be like him, sure. I'm not afraid of prison anymore. To spit in the soup, or to piss in the pool, or to forget about payment, and do it anyway. This is the Midwest, son. I, a white, as laden with boils as a corn cob, like the ward pressure and function or die, diving into the pig pen with swim goggles trimmed in tinsel, lenses waterproofed with soap. This is a bloodbath. ROTC ain't no Knights of the Round Table. Hanging from the rafters, spools of gray garlic and drying flags. After floating the great plains, we mounted this barn. After summoning the great winch, we lifted this tomb. We either or both hatched and escaped the camp. As per tradition, a whistle is placed inside each casket. She took me to the basement. Scraps of fuchsia carpet taped to the frozen concrete floor. She told me dinosaurs are a hoax because, have you ever seen a hush puppy with no smile or a fish with spider legs? Well, she said, touching my face, nobody knows when or how some insects came to wings. This is still the case. She pushed up her cotton sleeves, and I saw that she had been scratching or slicing, as a teenager does, the forearms. This curving bone betrays a species which failed to domesticate any dogs, yet seems to have been responsible for some attacks which have been passed on gangrene-esque, billowing into ships and thirsts for deeper and wider and wetter and deeper anguishes, so says. At least one repentant scholar. Self-harm proves neither survival of the fittest nor intelligent design. Take my class, take turns filling a granite-ware tub on the edge of protocol calls. Sewing felt, too. Punch up any newsletter. Wear a shiny dress. Distribute pamphlets against the high school's racist mascot. I'm sorry for stealing your story, the one about Mark shooting a state trooper in the face with a sawed-off shotgun. He was once considered a coward or crazy. Now the other inmates call him Sir.
So I have a little problem.
You really don't know what to do about it. So maybe you can help me. I'm going to show it to you.
Okay.
You can come over here a little closer, not too close.
Okay. So, do you think you could maybe...
Competition is a comforting role. A theater is a template for something we all want, supposedly. Not to be trapped. There should always be a clearly marked exit to survive and presumably be able to enjoy it. What if I don't want what you want? Battle cry. Make a plan. Advises an ad depicting a well-dressed, mixed-race family sitting on a porch by the ocean. Don't wait until it's too late. Communicate. What are the possibilities inherent to or caused by firm beliefs, solid senses of self? Is this system still just a grand order for who's authorized to murder whom? If I am central to the story, will the scriptwriter keep my character? Why is this country singer still alive? I realize that I am the sort of person who lies. Thus, all manner of attempts to fabricate optimism comes naturally to me. Also, I don't want what you want. I don't believe what you believe. I have no desire to be the protagonist.
Simone, do you want us to say money, not wealth?
Yes.
Cool.
Money! Wealth, money, plurality.
still not full. Kind of in the way, also. Money.
Plurality.
Creativity.
Courage. Authenticity.
Authenticity?
Authenticity.
I'm a good person.
Courage.
I have values.
Authenticity.
I'm a good person.
Courage.
I have values.
Authenticity.
What?
take a glass of water.
Charging interim changes preceding debate. An individual's only purpose is to contribute to, quote, humanity's ongoing conversation, end quote, about, quote, what to do with itself, end quote, he says, summarizing Einstein. His balls are bulging, shiny, purple, beneath the elastic band of shorts. He either intentionally shows them to me by lifting one leg or lets them escape as you lolls back in a black pleather office chair. But, quote, humanity is first not just one, quote, thing or, quote, single bodily made up of many dying and infinite puppets, I say. And my, quote, contribution might be better phrased. What are we going to do with you? What are we going to do with you? And I resent that any doing done at all has to deal with you. Some of us are not even ready to believe we can do something with ourselves, as the things which can be conversed about, the actions which might be done, definitions of humanity, and so on, are matters already ruined by your so vigorously violent attempts to contribute.
Good evening. The topic for this debate is, can we rely on ourselves? I, the speaker for the positive team, define this topic as a question about individual liberty and the ability of a person to know themselves and make decisions based on their own moral compasses and knowledges of self. I assert that we can, must, and should rely on ourselves. I assert that selves are the only things upon which we can rely. As the only speaker for the positive team, I will make 3 points. My first point is that an individual's ability to know themselves and rely on their own judgment in order to pursue life, liberty, and happiness is almost universally accepted as a definition of freedom. This definition of freedom is embedded in the United States Constitution, following the thought of John Rawls describing a society of free individual citizens holding equal basic rights and cooperating as reasonable persons to design a society that works for everyone. And within such a liberal picture, each individual must know what would work for themselves in order to advocate on their own behalf. And the picture itself must include every single individual. And today we continue to define freedom as having the agency to make decisions for ourselves, to love who we love, to pursue education and occupations that interest us, to be able to feed, house, and care for our bodies, to control our own bodies in alignment with our internal senses of self, and to make a vast array of personal decisions that enable us to live well and flourish. Each person and each group fights for this right. This fight rests in the belief that we can rely on ourselves. If we cannot rely on ourselves, we cannot participate in society or pursue our own individual happiness. My second point is that internal moral compasses and senses of right and wrong held and carried by individuals must be used to guide our socio-political actions. Hannah Arendt identifies the failure to maintain an internal sense of right, apart from societal pressure, as one of the banalities of evil. She describes how persons can be compelled to enact great violence when they cannot rely on themselves to judge the laws of their society and act against them when they do not match up with their own internal sense of right. When one's own society is enacting legalized evil, individuals must resist, using personal judgments and senses of justice. Using ourselves, including intuitions and gut feelings, as well as our personal experiences, beliefs, and knowledges to inform our actions, is advocated by Polonius when he says to Hamlet, "To thine own self be true," asking Hamlet to check in with himself about what is real and important and what is not. In essence, we know that external societal force, peer pressure, propaganda, and many other forms of conditioning can move individuals to act against their own best interests and against the best interests of others. Thus, we must be constantly checking in with ourselves about if what we are being told is really true, if what we are being asked to do is really right, and if how others see ourselves truly match up to how we indeed see and feel and recognize ourselves. My third and final point is that we care about ourselves more than anyone else does. We know ourselves better than anyone else does. Only we know our own sexual desires, our own senses of gender, our own spiritual experiences, and our own needs. It is important that we maintain a sense of self-identity and are able to fight for our own rights, establish boundaries, and maintain a sense of our inherent value as living human beings. When we have a strong sense of ourselves and our own values, we are able to make decisions that enable our own survival. Even in the face of systems such as capitalism that are constantly telling us we're merely the sum of our productivity, functionality, and use value akin to animals, machines, and raw materials. Also, when we have a strong sense of self and our own value, we are able to recognize and support others, including those very different from ourselves, without feeling threatened. The entire field of psychology is oriented around the mandate to help individuals rely on themselves, to help them see themselves clearly, to understand our motives, needs, and feelings and thoughts. Self-reflection and attachment of the self to the self defines maturity and psychological well-being. Not only does self-reliance make us more empowered participants of society, it also sustains our will to survive. Thus, I conclude that I argue that we can rely on ourselves and that we indeed must rely on ourselves.
Good evening, cherished guests. The topic for our debate tonight is whether or not we can rely on ourselves. I, the negative team, define the topic around the reliability of the self, asking us to consider how individuals form beliefs, values, and behaviors from within their own located conditioning. As the first and only speaker for the negative team, I will assert that we cannot and should not rely on ourselves, as our views are always subjective, and our senses of self and reality are located within what Gadamer calls the horizon, that boundary of perspective beyond which no self can ever see. My first point is that no individual self exists within a vacuum. Rather, our senses of right and wrong, for example, are constructed and enculturated by the societies within which we are born and raised. There is no pure, core, internal locus of self that is separate from or isolated from the world around the self. An individual is told wholly conditioned. Because an individual is wholly conditioned, we may not always know what is best for ourselves or for others. Thus, we form societies that can, hypothetically, form governing bodies, that justice systems, and ethical and religious senses of right and wrong. My second point is that the self is an unreliable narrator. Individuals' selves have emotions, reactions, assumptions, and superstitions that complicate our ability to rely on ourselves. No self can solely rely on themselves. To rely solely on the self is narcissism, and it is madness, especially when we may have experienced abuse or other deregulation of the self. We may not know what is best for ourselves. In some cases, we may even become detrimental to ourselves. Science shows that memory is totally unreliable, that our personal narratives tend to serve our own egos, and that our cultural biases are always present. My third point is that the self is... It is important to note that Hamlet is a tragedy. Everyone dies because nobody is capable of relying on any truth other than their own partial self-serving senses of truth and reality. If we wish to build a more equitable, just, and pluralistic society, then we must centralize viewpoints into a common sphere where everyone can perceive and contribute to them equally. We use dialectical analysis, journalism, history, art, and science to these purposes. My third point is that self-reliance is in and of itself a white supremacist, capitalist, and patriarchal value. It comes from individualism, which comes from social Darwinism, which wrongly perceives natural selection as a pitching of individuals' battles between individuals, rather than as an increasing biotic entanglement for the good of all those involved. One has only to ask a person who may conceive, nurture, and care for children whether or not the self-reliance of an individual determines their value, to see how using self-reliance to show how a person is valuable causes hegemonies and hierarchies between those who are willing to dominate others and those who do not value such forms of dominance or power paradigms. In conclusion, I insist that self-reliance is we should not rely on ourselves because individuals are subjective, because the self is not a reliable narrator, and because self-reliance in and of itself is a value that should not be centralized. Thank you.
Okay, all right, so now we need to vote on who won this debate. So, who would like to vote for the positive team arguing that you can rely on yourself? Any takers? Any takers? One taker. All right, any other takers? Two, three, four, five. Did I count you?
No.
No, six, seven, eight, nine. I feel like I'm counting. Okay, that's good. Okay, so now who would like to vote for the negative team arguing that you cannot rely on yourself? One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Anyone else? Did I miss anyone? Okay. So that was eight votes for the positive team and nine votes for the negative team.
Yes! Yes!
Thereby,
yes!
Cannot rely on ourselves.
Yes! In your face!
I'm okay. This. I
can move on. All right, to the next. And then also have your cards.
Desiring the last text. Into a champagne sedan, the man in a pink satin jacket packs cardboard boxes. He is looking up into the valves at the crown of the asphalt silos, cursing what he calls Mother Nature. That witch whose environments are indistinguishable, each a gross ravine, river, sewer, street. In each of his boxes is a vacuum-sealed, wait for it, body part. Our hero's most fascinating obsession. Wow, made for TV. Nothing but compulsion drives us directly into the center of blaming human nature as some drive, motivation, or ongoing factuality. That which seems to drive the willful subject to choose this car over that one. Does it matter what we think, that we think, that we think we can think? The right-wing blogger who hates postmodernism blames a change to what he calls the core question. Once, he says, conservatives thought human nature was complex, mixing good and evil in the breast, each day and nighttime lapsing over the plains and plain open fields of doing. Then times, when, the liberals thought all were inherently good and neglected to protect the weak and pale from the hordes or even from her husband, too far gone into believing that a just society would create just action. This is a question of responsibility. Is it his fault that he's so drunk? He blames the ever self-reflection, the new question one, he says, posed by mouth breathers lurking in the rubble of towers fallen, dragging broken chains, dragging attack dogs, dragging worthless steel pieces down the sidewalk, making a sound some artists might call noise music, oxycontin morons. The sound of miseries braided into night jobs, those libtards crying out, is there any human nature? Is there anything at all? The director of the critical theory department agrees, mostly bemoaning the breakdown of meta-narratives, the fragmentation of mills into rusting ruins, charred arms without trays to hold aloft, but not these real things, really, just the collapse of dialectic borders, which I imagine, always confusion, fantasy fiction with history, as circles of robed old men, philosophers, or wizards, padding by candlelight over designs inlaid into marble floors, chanting, sometimes kissing. He says, all moral good comes down to protecting private property and keeping the personal inside the house. She says, the maternal must be brought out into the open, the doors and windows broken, all singularities of self made visible and substantial. I picture the two of them sitting in parked trucks, each eating sandwiches. His is slimy deli ham with mayo on white bread, of course, and hers is sprouts, activated charcoal, and raw crawfish on rye toast. They are looking like detective and serial killer in a 7-season Netflix show through their windshield at each other, generating a standoff where there is only mutual respect and potentially heteronormative sexual tension. They agree fundamentally, if there is human nature, there is universal morality, and if there is no human nature, there is no reason to believe that everyone is good. They both orbit the inquiry, are some people better than others? What I have to say is, this is the wrong question. Still, I am never sure. Should I be more afraid of losing you, of losing my grip on you, and falling from your arms, or should I be more afraid of dragging you down, pulling you under? When I'm gone, brush your teeth, please, for the love of all the other prisoners.
I feel like I have a small problem that I would like to talk about a little bit. Oh, I guess you could do that first. So, okay, that's fine.
Leave it alive. I'll
leave it alive. Okay.
Wait, what's the radio? That
was a few years ago.
Okay, sentence one, you did it. Next sentence.
Laura's really like driving back in her feet. It sounds good. I'm trying to
They're what?
They were so bad. They were not impressed. They left without buying anything. It was not the experience I remember as a kid. Wow.
That was the one review.
Now, teammates, without exception, everyone is now a gardener. All hordes shall be released wildly to the garden. Stop buying and selling the bullshit. Unreserved fecundity is the natural order. When in doubt, do nothing. Don't be productive. Stop profiting. Marvel at the sky or thank a mountain. Build, tend, and nurture the garden. It is all life and death.
So, Kaia, you said you had some kind of problem?
Well, I know. I feel embarrassed, though, because I said it at the wrong time, and I don't really feel like I should say it, because, you know.
No, you should say it.
Well, it's kind of, I feel like you won't believe me if I tell you, pretty much.
I'll believe you.
It's really weird.
I mean, I usually believe what you say.
Okay. So, do you remember when I was telling you about my hand hurting a lot?
I mean, no, but yeah, I guess.
Well, I mean, it was hurting, but it's gotten a lot worse lately is the problem, and I actually can't sleep. It's keeping me up.
That sucks. I'm sorry.
Yeah, I mean, but it's the weird thing is that it doesn't hurt me, even though it's pain. But it's not like I injured my hand, I didn't break it, I didn't do anything to it. It's just really strange.
Well, what does it feel like?
I mean, it feels like my hand is shape-shifting.
What? That's ridiculous.
No,
I believe you.
You do?
Yeah, I mean, is that why you're wearing an oven mitt?
Yeah!
Okay, well, can you see anything on it, or is this like psychosomatic?
You can see something.
Okay, can I see?
I mean, yeah.
All right. Oh my god.
Yeah, it's a lot going on.
Holy shit!
So, it's really...
That's so crazy!
It's kind of a problem for me when I'm trying to do tasks, like emails, or... you know,
yeah,
get dressed.
Yes,
like,
really going crazy.
Doing
there.
Things. But the thing is that I feel really worried about is that I really do feel like it's migrating, like it's kind of moving through my body, up my arm, and also it's getting into all of my internal organs, and I just, like, I'm not sure what I will do at any moment in
okay,
time.
Yeah, Kaia,
I used to
Kaia,
feel
Kaia,
like
Kaia.
I could sort of,
if
it,
can
like,
you
feel
like
sorry,
this?
I'm just,
stop it!
I really, I
you're
don't,
like, you're ruining
I'm,
this whole thing. What are
so,
you doing?
I used to be a performer, and I, you know,
okay,
I just
cannot,
feel like
not,
not the
like
same
this.
As
no,
other
no, no.
humans,
I'm
and
really
I'm
sorry,
like,
guys. I'm really sorry, that's all we can do.